Hello, my friend. Welcome to the show. We are friends, aren't we? I've waited for you. I've waited. Yes. So I do hope our time together proves enlightening. There's no need to worry. I'm here to help you. Think of me as your guide into the unknown. It's exciting, yes, and terrifying. But if you're brave enough, if you let me help you, I can help you. We can help each other. You didn't find anything, and so I've nothing to show you. You need to look harder. The cards are out there. If you don't help me, how can I help you? We're supposed to be friends. You said so yourself. Search harder. Only you can find them. There are secrets out there, you know. Secrets and lies. Paths to uncover on which I can shed light, if you let me. Help me help you. And remember, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Peace and love.
See you later, kids.
Yeah, Hackett's Quarry forever.
You know how many hearts are broken on the last day of summer camp? It's like a romance apocalypse.
Hmm. And you never know. The universe has a kind of way of working these things out.
The universe?
Yeah, like the cosmic space gods.
Space gods.
You heard me?
Okay, spell it.
It's nothing to spell. You know, we're cool.
Oh, so cool.
We are super cool.
So she dumped her ass, huh?
Okay, quit it.
Hi, Emma.
Hey.
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before, right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Be a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will you?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
Hey, what are you listening to? Before they knew it, the whole place was up in smoke. Good to know. Hey, are you guys gonna help with the bags or what?
Oh, you know, I was actually just working on fixing the door. It's
Dylan, come
it's
on,
broken.
Dylan, please.
I can't. It's.
I gotta get the last bags
in
there. Come on.
What's wrong with this thing? It's just
Dylan.
Closing.
Please.
Sorry, bro.
Cool. Thanks, guys. Skill. Ugh. Horror. I hate horror. All right, got the bags.
Great, all by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my God, you are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Okay, you're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma, are you, son?
Okay, I'm gonna need you back all the way out of my business, Caitlin.
Well, excuse me for trying to help.
How is making me feel shitty about being dumped supposed to help?
Aha, the plot thickens. She took out the trash.
What? No.
Wait, check that. First, she cleaned the house. Then, she took out the trash. Then, she washed her hands. Bye-bye, Jake. Now she's a trash of single, clean hands, ready to mingle.
Are you finished?
Oh, I could go all day.
Yeah, no thanks.
Man, you're starting to bum me out, Jake.
What? Yeah, you know, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're one sorry motherfucker, ain't ya?
Okay, well, at least I went for it this summer.
What's that supposed to mean?
Ryan?
What about him? He's a guy at this camp who just happens to have this whole hot, sexy loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all.
Oh, and the plot thickens.
So she really just dumped you just like that?
Well, technically no, but you know, she realized that she has her plans, and I have my plans, and it wasn't going to work after today, you know? And today's already over, isn't it?
And you didn't want to try, like, long distance or whatever? Man, she has got you wrapped all the way around that cute little finger of hers.
Okay, you know what? Maybe you're right. Maybe she does have, like, this superpower over me. But you know what? Maybe I like it.
Oh, likes it. Check. Totally not in denial.
Oh,
check.
Okay. Wow, the fumes of jealousy are just stifling over here.
Excuse me?
I'm just saying, I guess some girls don't have what it takes to hang with the big dog.
You're a real charmer, you know that?
Look, I'm just saying, I don't know why you didn't make a move on Ryan. You should have seized the moment.
Well, can't seize a moment that never happened.
Yeah, well, you can't wait for it to come to you. You gotta make the moment happen yourself.
Oh, right. Chase the moment around all summer like a dog with two dicks until it dumps you on the last day of camp.
Okay. Not gonna miss you, Caitlin. Okay, so are we sure that this old rust bucket's roadworthy?
We'll take a look. It better be. One more night in the great outdoors might actually kill me.
Hey! What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Well, I haven't killed you yet. You're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up.
Okay, so, total hypothetical, but if I was, like, a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd probably break the fuel line or, I don't know, rip out the rotor arm. And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Okay, and what does a rotor arm look like again?
It's like an arm that's all rotary. You know, it's under the little black dome with the leads poking out. Jake, you do realize that even if we somehow did get stuck out here, one more night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, Chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure.
Guess we'll just have to find out. Oh, this looks important. I will hook you right back up tomorrow, okay? Pinky promise.
Up here, my dudes.
Why did they look like they're up to something?
Hey, Jacob.
What? No, dude, please. Don't.
Belong.
Oh, Dick! Boom. Oh. There it is.
Oh, ooh. Man, good sight.
Freak.
Oh. Ooh, I wish I had some singles.
Freaks. I'm surrounded by freaks. Oh, thank God. I'm gonna get the whole no technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault, is it?
You know, you should really just save it for emergencies only. Unless, of course, is being dumped an emergency?
Oh, Ben.
Okay, well, at least I had a relationship this summer.
Ooh, damn, now we burned.
Yeah, well, maybe not everyone is looking for a hookup.
Okay, let's all put our little dicks away and get this show on the road, huh?
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick, you're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any chick he wants.
Okay, yeah, keep dreaming, Junior.
Hey there, party bear.
Status report?
We are officially empty nesters. High five up top.
Oh boy, you're about to get your phone back, aren't you?
Let's go collect our bags and away from this mosquito-infested backwoods dump.
Doors locked, bags inside.
Fuck me.
Yep.
Well, it's obvious what we have to do here.
Find someone with a key?
Shape our destiny. Then by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Okay, let's do it. We better not get into trouble.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
Mr. Hackett's gonna find out.
So what? He'll just think it was a bear or something.
Have you ever seen a bear in these woods?
No, but that doesn't mean they're not out there.
Fair point.
All right, let's do this. On three. One, two, three! All about the power of positive thinking.
Why do I ever listen to you?
Because I'm always right.
Are you sure they're gonna think it was a bear?
Oh my God, relax. It's not like we killed someone.
All right, well, I'm just gonna take another look around, make sure we didn't miss anything.
Go nuts!
Aw. This was little Izzy's.
I want to play a game!
Let's get you back to Izzy. Why would this place be in the news? Can't believe I'm actually gonna miss all those lumpy, loose springs. It's gonna be weird not waking up to Dylan's morning announcements. Ouch. Let's hope Jacob hasn't seen this. Ugh. Ew, what is that? Is it Dylan's?
Ready to roll?
Let's do it.
Finally.
Time to let loose and vamoose this caboose.
How are you so
dramatic?
Annoying. Confident.
It's just acting. It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself, but louder. You should try it sometime. You never know who you might impress.
Nah. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there.
Oh, wow! Oh. Nice steering, Tex.
Jinkies. Okay, so hypothetically, if I were to put myself out there, what if he ends up being a dud, kind of like you and Jacob?
He's actually really sweet.
Then why'd you quit it?
Summer fling. We're going to school like 4 states away. He gets it.
Yeah, sure.
But that's us. You and Nick could be different. When do you get his handle? Hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email. It was in the packet they gave to us on the first day.
Email? Are you 93?
What's wrong with email?
I'm really gonna miss you, Abby.
Oh, hold up!
Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route? One last victory lap around the camp?
Sure. What's the victory?
2 months.
No technology.
I kind of thought it was nice to be offline.
Ugh, I didn't. Plus, my subs need me.
You know what? I actually believe you.
Abby, was that a compliment?
Your charm is infectious. What can I say? I'd subscribe.
You better. As soon as you get home, sub, share, smash that like button. The Holy Trinity.
Okay, well, now I'm really regretting it.
Oh, no, you love me. My favorite spot?
The fire pit?
The island. Mad secluded, right? Is that smoke?
Should we tell someone?
It looks pretty contained. It's probably just Mr. H burning some stuff before, you know, he closes camp for the summer.
Yeah. Speaking of which, we should probably, you know, get back.
Oh, yeah. Worried Nick's, you know, gonna leave without you?
Well, no. They're probably, like, all waiting for us.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Everyone, yeah. Nick, waiting for you. All, everyone, sing.
Don't worry, Jacob. I got you. I got a full tank of gas, so... Oh, fuck me.
Oh, idiot.
Does nobody own phone chargers anymore?
Hey, there's no signal out here anyways, dude, okay? This place is, like, patchy as balls.
Your balls are patchy?
What? No!
It's okay. I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before we go.
Ew.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like to know? Ignore her, please. Let's go. Just gotta get these bags up onto the...
Oh, hey, here. Let me get it for you.
I can take care of my own bag, thank you. What?
Are you sure? Because, I mean, it's really not that big of a deal.
She can take care of her own bag, thank you.
We can both take care of our own bag, thank you.
Cool.
Abby, do you need...
Yeah.
Can I...
Thank you. Hey, has anyone seen Ryan?
Oh yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little knee party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
What's it about?
Yeah, what's it about? Is it about me?
You think I was listening to a podcast about you?
Okay, if anyone here had a podcast about them, it'd be me.
Yeah, if there was a podcast called How to Look and Smell Like a Butt.
Oh my god, you are so childish.
At least I don't look and smell like a butt.
No, it's a paranormal podcast. This episode was actually about this place, weirdly enough. The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
The who of the what's it where now? What's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
You don't know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
If I did, would I be asking, dumbass?
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's just this campfire story for the kids. It's, there's supposedly an old woman who died in a fire a few years back. She haunts the woods looking for her lost baby boy. There are, like, reports of whispers or whatever, and then this figure that floats around, you know, textbook ghost stuff. Some people say that if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son. Or kill you. Or something. I don't know. It's never really been clear. Anyways, Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
You made that up.
It's right here in the podcast, man.
Cool story, bro.
Seriously, though, you should have seen the first time you told the story to the kids at the campfire. They were scarred for life.
I mean, not for life.
You gotta be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Come on, dude, bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Nearly done, Mr. H.
Well, hop to it. Get those butts in gear.
Sorry, Mr. H.
You had to liberate some luggage.
Shut up. Maybe if somebody didn't spend so much time trying to press the ladies' ball as ghost stories.
You asked.
Ghost stories?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Oh!
Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go. Give me a hand, would you, Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Cool, yeah. No worries.
Good man.
No big deal. You can share my earbuds.